we're going to take a look at what's called the photoelectric effect. Now, we all know who Albert Einstein is. We know his theory of relativity, E equals MC squared. But we need to realize that he never won a Nobel Prize for that theory. What he won it for was the photoelectric effect. Now, we said that Planck and Albert Einstein both theorized that light was made up of what they called small packets of energy. Now, it wasn't until later on that we moved away from these packets of energy or quantums of energy to the more modern term photon. So we're going to say a single particle of this quantized packet of electromagnetic energy was later named a photon. So a photon is just a light particle. Now, according to Einstein's photoelectric effect, when photons with enough energy strike the surface of a metal, they'll be able to knock electrons off of the surface of the metal. In that way, we use the word emitting. The metal is emitting electrons. Electrons are coming off the surface of the metal. Now, we're going to say the energy that's required to do this is directly proportional to our frequency. And we know this because we said that frequency and energy are directly related. So it's tied to the frequency rather than the amplitude. Remember, amplitude just measures the intensity of the light. If it has a high amplitude, it's very bright. We're going to say the photoelectric effect only happens when photons with a certain threshold frequency strike the surface of the metal. This is the photoelectric effect. It's just saying that if I have a photon with enough energy and I toss it towards the surface of a metal, it can knock off electrons off of that surface of that metal.